Good afternoon, YouTube. So today we have some of these 4-cell Aris modem backup batteries. So these are, again, 8.4 volts, but 4,400 milliamp hours. So they're set up as 2P2S. And they're a little bit different than the 8-cell. They have the same little yellow pull strap. So you take those off. And I use pretty much the same technique to open these. And I put the blade right on the seam there. And what you want to do is get this end to crack. So we put it right there. And you can see one pop, we got that to crack. And then the same thing here, get it lined up. Oh, yeah, there we go. Yeah, that one's cracked. Then you flip it over and just repeat on the other side. 4 pops and we got it open. And these have quite a wide variety of cells. There's Samsung, Sony, LG, let's see, there's a Moly, and then there's a one cell I haven't identified yet. It's red. Let's see, maybe we can take a look at some of these other ones, just see what we get here. Oh, see, that one didn't quite crack all the way, so I've got to give it a second pop there. And the same down there, I didn't get that end. There we go. Oh, nope, didn't quite get it. Yeah, some of these are a little bit tougher. There we go. Yeah, there's another Samsung. There we go. You just got to get that end to crack. So that one cracked. Right there. Yeah, these are the Sony cells. And let's see, let's just try one more here. One, and two, three, and four, and another Sony. Yeah, now these are the earlier one. They've got a really light adhesive and it peels right off. So this one here probably will come out too. Yeah, there we go. You can see it comes out clean, where these later model ones are really glued in there. So let me go put these in the sunshine. What I do is let the sun shine on the black plastic side and let those heat up for about 15 minutes, and then we'll try to get the cells out of there. So we got our 10 battery packs here. This time came out with 5 of the Sony batteries. There were 2 that had Samsung, 2 of them had the LGs, and then there's these red cells. I can't find any of these numbers that match up to anything. UB3 EAY something or other on there. So these guys are glued in really tough, so you need your bent putty knife here, and you just do the same thing as the 8-cell. You make one cut down there, one down there, give it a little bit of a pry. Like this one is pretty tough. And you want to go down this side because all the wires are on the other side. There we go, almost there. You can see these were glued in pretty good. Those are the Samsungs. Same thing, just down the side. This one doesn't feel quite as tight. And there you go. Try one more here, and that one isn't too bad. Really helps if you set the battery in the sun for maybe 10-15 minutes on the black side. Seems to soften up the adhesive a bit, like that. So yeah, and then these, they process pretty much the same way as the 8-cell, except for one difference. So I like to go and remove all the circuit boards here. And we just want to cut one wire at a time. Like I say, I normally try to cut all the circuit boards off, but I'll show you the cleanup here. They're pretty much the same at this point. I just like to get rid of as much of the tape as I can, any extra insulation, and so you get the tape off, and there's usually a piece or two on the side holding these together. So you get the cells opened up like this, so you have 2 parallel connections on this end, your plus and minus, And then on the other end, there's two series connections. So these are wired as two series. So it's this cell in series with this cell, and then it's this cell in series with this one, and then the two series cells are wired in parallel. Yeah, so my battery holders work with paired cells. So this end, the positive and negative, are wired in parallel. You got two positives and two negatives. The other end is wired in series. So I need to cut this end, but I've got to get this end apart so I can cut the other end. So I take my razor blade, make a slice there, turn it around, and you want to keep your hands out of the way, and you don't want to cut across. You just cut from the middle out. Now you can separate the two cells, and at this point, these two ends should be pretty close to the same voltage, but I'd still like to only cut one side at a time. So I snip that one and this one. Now I've got two pairs. I've got the positives and the negatives. And I need to get rid of these tabs so that I can spot weld this end together. And then I have to get rid of those two tabs so I can spot weld this end together. So yeah, usually you can get these off pretty easy. Yeah, that one came off pretty clean. And then these, I like to take the insulators off the negative end. They get in the way of spot welding. The negatives, you don't need those. And then these are the positive ends. So these, you want to keep the insulators in place. So there we got that one and that one. Now I take these inside and spot weld those two pairs back together. Okay, so once I have the cells all cleaned up, I bring them inside. And I need to put them in this holder here so I can spot weld the ends. So these were the two ends that were connected in series to these two cells. And the reason I have to remove the tabs is that it's a really tight fit in this holder. And if you don't remove the tabs off the top, you can't get the new tab on top of the old tabs. Yeah, so there we go. We've got the two new sets of tabs in there. And then I come along here. So there we go. I give them like two spot welds in the holder there. And then I usually come back and get one on the back side where it was inside the cell holder. And I'll usually give it a fourth one just to make sure it's good and tight. Give it a little twist there. So this is my iCharger 4010 Duo. So this charger has two separate charging circuits in it. And I have a pair of four cell holders. So I load all four pair out of two of the modem batteries in here because these were all pretty close. And so this one's showing 3.526 volts. Not sure if you can see the display there, but I'll just hit that. And I've got a 2-amp charging profile loaded in here, and I'm charging them to 4 volts per cell. The reason I picked up this charger, it does regenerative discharging, and it also can be powered off of a 24 volt power supply. This charger is connected to the 24 volt system, so when I get to testing the larger modules, I can do regenerative discharging from this into my 24 volt battery bank, and I can do that like overnight. And then let me show you what I do next. Just to maintain consistency with my earlier testing, I'm using the same iCharger 1010 to finish charging the cells. So you can see I've got a 2-amp charge to 4 volts going on, and then I've got another 4 pair of cells in there. So the iCharger is bringing all these up to 4 volts. So in this case, the cells were at 3.92 out of the 4010 Duo charger, so it had shut off a little early. So I just bring the cells in here and then top them off. So this goes pretty quick because the cells are almost fully charged. Yeah, we'll wait till this finishes charging and then we'll take the cells out and
get them ready for the discharge test. So that's pretty much the process of going through these cells. So yeah, if you have any questions or comments, leave that in the comment section below. And stay tuned for future videos. As always, thanks for watching.